Oh boy, it's impedance. This stuff's pretty important. Like, you'll need to know impedance. I don't really feel like I need to say what it's for, but whatever. Just knowing about it will help you avoid lifeless guitar sounds, glitchy tech, and fried microphones. And when it comes to finding out what impedance is, you can find a whole bunch of info on it, but they're not helpful. They're all cryptic. And some of them lie to you. But there are people who explain it thoroughly. The problem is, it's not in English. Or, well, it is. But a lot of times you'll either get a vague definition, slow video, or one of these. Impedance is dumb. And it's stupid. And it's stupid. And it's dumb. But that's okay. It's alright. Because I'm about to explain all this shit right now. So what is impedance? Well, if you looked it up into any one of the dumb articles I've been talking about, I can guarantee you'll find something along the lines of, impedance is the extension of the definition of resistance to alternating currents. Okay, so what this means is that impedance includes two things. Resistance to AC, which stands for alternating currents, and the resistance being the opposition of the electric current that causes heat, and the second one being reactance. This is the measure of the opposition itself.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Well, here, look. Impedance is basically the resistance to electricity.
Oh. Okay. Well, whatever.
But hey, if you don't pay any attention to these things called ohms, you might blow up your goddamn speakers. Yes, this is necessary to pay attention to. You're an engineer, not a visitor to electric mania. Guess the voltage. Win a prize!
120 volts?
No. It's too low. Okay, so what are these ohm things we're talking about now? An ohm derives from Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that the current through a conductor between two points is directly proportional to the voltage across the two points. Proportionality, aka the resistance, is determined by the usual mathematical equation that describes this relationship, which is V equals IR. See, doesn't this look familiar? We all know what V equals IR is.
I don't get it.
Okay, well, to put it in English, basically, ohms are units of resistance. The more ohms you have, the more resistance there is. So these ohms are generally what you're going to be seeing on, like, your headphones and stuff like that. Let's put it in a real-life situation. You buy a headset, but the thing has 50 ohms. There's no way in hell your computer's garbage sound card that came with your motherboard is going to be able to power that thing without it sounding like a donkey's ass.
But my computer has 7.1 surround sound support.
Doesn't matter. We're talking about the ohms here. To power that thing, you're going to need a sound card that has the proper voltage to support these amazing headphones. If you vape, this stuff even applies to your mod. Can you believe it? Some people actually sub-ohm their mods to increase the power output to the coils, thus giving you more vape to blow in people's faces. And by the term sub-ohm, you can assume that it means taking out some ohms. See, so before you spend your money on an amazing headset, you might want to consider the fact that your computer can't even power that thing. You might want to buy a headphone amp or a powerful sound card, like this. But that implies that you know how to install it in your computer. Good luck! And yeah, that's basically impedance. Resistance to your electric current, voltage, power. I don't know. I mean, I do know. I know what I've been talking about this whole video. You can't tell me that I don't know. This video's done. Now I'm gonna roll pointless credits.